make some time. Stopped off at a truck stop to see an old waitress friend of mine. They said, she's in the hospital and it's not too far away. And if you want to see her, well, you better get over there today. She didn't look too good, and yeah, I knew it was close to the end. Yeah, I tried to smile and cheer her up, but kind of hard to lose a friend. And then she looked up at me and gave me a little wink. Said, don't worry, Hoss. Not as bad as you think. I've been everywhere and, you know, I've done everything. My only regret in life was I never got to meet the king. I said, are you talking about Jesus? And she said, oh no, bless my soul. Talking about the boy from Memphis, the king of rock and roll. She said, Billy, I got all of his records and I even got a lock of his hair. Well, maybe if I'm good, I'll see him when I get up there. And then the nurse told me she needed a rest, and I said, I understand. And I thought, well, she wants to meet the king, and I got a little plan. So I grabbed some yellow pages that were sitting by the elevator. Called up a talent agency and I said, send me over an impersonator. Send somebody real good now, not somebody that just does it for a hobby. Tell him to meet me tomorrow at the hospital, say around noon in the lobby. Well, the next day I was outside in the parking lot having a smoke. And up rolled this big limo and out jumped this guy in a suit and a cloak. From the suit to the way he said, honka honka, to the big diamond ring. Man, if you closed your eyes, you would have sworn it was the king. And we burst in a room and I said, hey darling, I got you a surprise. And the king of rock and roll walked in the room and tears filled her eyes. Then he plugged in his jam box and he said, come on everybody, we're gonna have a little fun. And that whole hospital room began to shake to the strains of 2001. He danced across the floor and he knelt down beside her. Sang all the hits like Hound Dog, Teddy Bear, and of course, CC Rider. Then he took her by the hand and began to sing. Wise men say. Yeah, if I never saw happiness before, I saw it that day. And we were making a lot of racket, and I hope the others weren't starting to hate us. All of a sudden, he made a bunch of karate moves and he went into Viva Las Vegas. I'm thinking, man, this is amazing the way he turns this room into a stage. And wouldn't you know it, over the intercom, I get a page. It was the guy from the talent agency and I said, thanks a lot. I gotta tell you, this guy you sent, he ain't nothing but hot. He said, hey pal, I know you're upset. And, yeah, it's okay. See, the impersonator was in a car wreck and that's why he didn't show up earlier today. I said, what do you mean he didn't show up? He said, he didn't, I gotta go, that's all. And then I saw a soft light kinda coming from the room at the end of the hall. I ran as fast as I could, but he'd vanished into space. Gladys's eyes were closed and there was a smile on her face. And then I found the note that read, thank you, friend, I'm touched. Now Elvis and I have left the building, but thank you.
Thank you very much.